Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy 1. Eric M and Twins 20 here. How you doing, everybody? We are on episode 3. We are about ready to go into the marsh cave. So let's take a look at some things I've done off camera. We got level 4 magic for myself. We're all caught up on level 4 for Kelly, and we are all caught up on level 4 for Alex. In the equipment, got iron nunchucks for Ryan, leather cap, armor, and gloves. We have the mithril sword for Eric, leather cap, chainmail, and leather gloves. Hammer, leather cap, and gloves for Kelly, and dagger, leather cap, and gloves for Alex. So we are ready to go. We also, in the items, 99 potions, 19 antidotes, a cottage and a tent, and a couple gold needles in case we get stoned. So we are ready to go. We are at the marsh cave, and we are looking to go get the crown. And then take it back to the Western Keep. Got some zombies and ghouls. We're just going to run. I am going to set up Daya too in case we get into a little bit of a pickle. Because you never know with these guys. They might start paralyzing my guys and I'd be screwed. So we're going to make our way through the marsh cave. We've been through this before in the last playthrough. So we're going to head down here into that room. And I believe the broadsword is in there. But we're going to end up selling it because we already have one. Or no, we have the mithril sword. Excuse me. I did buy a broadsword off camera to upgrade before, and then I got enough money where I ended up buying the mithril sword because it was a better fit for Eric. More damage created, so that worked out in my favor. I ended up going to the Peninsula of Power northeast of Provoca and grinding there a few times, and it worked out to my favor as we get a steel plate here, which does not fit on anybody. We'll end up selling that as well. So yeah, my grinding up at the peninsula helped out. We upgraded several levels, as well as we got the money we needed to upgrade all the magic and then fill up my potions and upgrades in armor and weaponry. So I'm looking at these different rooms here on this level. This one's got the cottage, so now we have two cottages, which is good to have. And we are taking on some gargoyles. We're gonna end up running here. And I'll tell you what, working on this playthrough of the marsh cave has been a lot easier than the last playthrough, that's for sure. As we get proper armlet here. And I believe this is in the glove compartment. Yep, glove compartment. Significant increase for Ryan. Good increase for Eric, but a downgrade in defense. Increase for Kelly on defense and invasion, as well as Alex. I think I accidentally added it. I want to check others first and see what. Yeah, it's definitely an upgrade. It's a 1 point decline in invasion, but I think it works out. I think we end up giving it to Alex. I think of all the guys, that's what we do, because everybody else, it's a downgrade. So we're gonna head back this way, and believe this is the room. Yep, that's the room where the crown is. So we're gonna leave that for a minute. We're gonna go over here because I never do check this room over here. I think there is something in here. We're gonna check that after this battle with gargoyles, which we're gonna end up running again. So we'll get 385 gold, so that's nice. So now we're gonna go ahead and do this. Make sure everybody's all healed up. Looks like Ryan needs to be healed up. He's got about 20 points behind. Everybody else is ready to go. Eric's only off by one, but that's fine. It's just 1 point. So here we go, taking on some Pisco demons, excuse me. There's four of them. So we're gonna hit some bolt on them. We're gonna put, I believe we're gonna put a shield around Eric. Yes, are we? Nope, we're gonna put it around Alex. And then we're gonna fire to the Pisco demons. As Eric's, Ryan's already taking a hit. He's taking quite a bunch of hits. There's one on Alex. And a lightning bolt. They're not taking the magic all that hard. They're putting up a decent fight here, which is kind of surprising. I figured it'd be a little harder. So I'm gonna fire ice too. And Alex is gonna hit him with fire. The ice knocks out three of the four. That's a good shot. As Kelly heals up Ryan a little bit, and he takes and hits out the last Pisco demon. So we beat them. Very good HP, and we get a lot of gold. And we have now obtained the crown. So if you wanted to grind, you could stick here and go back and forth to that spot. But we're not going to do that. We're going to head out of here. There's nothing in there. As we get another enemy, green slime. We're going to run. We're going to try and get out of this marsh cave as fast as possible. Gonna heal up on some magic, I believe. Yep. Ryan definitely needed it. Looks like Eric needs a little bit as well. As does Alex. So we'll get everybody healed up here and make our way out of the marsh cave and get out of here. Hopefully with minimal damage. Another trio of gargoyles. Gonna run again. And Kelly gets us out of it. But once we're out of the cave, we will fast forward ahead to the Western Keep, because it'll be a long walk back. Yep, she's gonna hit Dia too, just in case. And we get out of it. Looks like Ryan got us out of that, maybe. Lots of encounters in this playthrough, I'll tell you that. It was really annoying at times having all these encounters. And at one point, it was like I was going to encounter every two steps. Like, I'd step, boom, 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 monster. Step, monster. After that, a couple steps, another monster attacks. Like, what the heck is going on here? It was getting frustrating. But we got through it. Or we will get through it. And now we will fast forward to the Western Keep. Gonna save first, because as you guys know from previous playthroughs, Astos will shoot Reaper, and there's a chance somebody could die here. So once I got out of the marsh cave, as you saw before, we fast forward. I hit the memo save, so in case I died between there and here, we would just start up back where we were. But we made it, so that made me save the cottage. Ha ha, fools! I'm the great king of the dark elves, Astos! Shit! Ooh.
Thank you ever so much for retrieving the crown. With the crystal eye here, I shall become the true elf king. You fools have served your purpose. To the underworld you will go.
Alright, this is Astos. We've seen him before in the last playthrough. So we're gonna hit him with Ryan with haste. Kelly's gonna shield him. And Alex is gonna hit steel. Just remember all this. So I get 4 hits on him after that. There's steel. There's shield. Okay, we just did all that, and now watch what Astos is about to do. Yeah. I hate this guy. So all that defense for Ryan, and he gets murdered. Yeah. I love it. I thought I'd try Daya, but it obviously didn't work. He's not undead. So we just hit him with fire over and over, which doesn't do hardly anything. He takes a hit on me, but doesn't hurt too much. So she's going to cure me, and we're going to hit him with ice too. Yeah, so fighting him with weapons isn't anything, as ice works good on him. I noticed that. I'm like, ooh, that worked good. So she heals me up, and then so we're gonna hit him with ice too twice here, as she's going to cure, or she's gonna put a shield around me to protect me, even though it didn't help Ryan out. He's gonna try and cast slow too on me. A little ice on him. 53, and that's it. We defeated Astos minus 1 party member, so Ryan will be behind, but you'll see later. That's actually not a big deal. The others catch up to him, so that's not too bad. So we have obtained, as it is about to announce, we have obtained a crystal Y. So we're going to go and fast forward. I'm going to save here once we get out of the Western Keep. And we're going to head back to Cornelia, where it's cheaper to revive and save. As while we're pulling in, we're going to go revive Ryan and then reshuffle the formation. And then we're going to go save, and then we're going to go up to Matoya. Excuse me, ma'am. All that just to walk in front of me and move back.
I hate it when people do that.
So Ryan is revived, and now we're up back at Matoya's. Get her the crystal eye, which will give us the jolt tonic. Thump. Ow! The crystal eye, the crystal eye. Ow!
Curses! I can't see a thing without the crystal eye. Who on earth stole it away from me? Is that my crystal eye? Give it to me! Here, I'll give you the most wondrous potion from my collection.
Obtain Jolt Tonic. So now we're gonna go...
Ah, now I can see everything.
Okay, now we're gonna go head back to Elfheim. I could only get one of those treasure chests, by the way, because the potions were at 99. So once we get the airship and I use some of the potions, we'll come back later and collect those. So I did manage to get an antidote. Here we go.
The Jolt Tonic. This will surely awaken the prince. We must try it at once. Your Highness.
Oh, it seems as if I was caught in a never-ending dream.
Am I still dreaming, or do I see the legendary warriors? It is not a dream. Then the time has come to pass the mystic key to its rightful master, as foretold by legend. Obtained mystic key. Thank you, warriors. I'm quite well now, and I'm such a bitch. Okay, so we're gonna head over to the treasure chest.
He has awakened at last. Thank you so much.
So we're gonna go head over to the treasure room and get the stuff in the room here. So hug the wall till you get to the room. He'll just tell you this room's locked, blah, blah, blah. Mithril hammer, 400 gil, 330 gil, and a bronze glove, which we already have. I think we already had a mithril hammer, if I'm not mistaken. We have the sword. Oh, no, we didn't have a mithril hammer. We do now, so we're going to upgrade that. But those bronze gloves, nobody can wear them, so we're going to chuck those. We're going to sell them. So we're going to... Do we go back to town or do we get out of here? I don't remember. Hang on a second. Let's see what happens. Nope, we are going to go back to town. Because we do have stuff we gotta sell. So we're going to come down here to the weapon shop. It was an episode or two ago. I accidentally said armor shop when I was going into the weapon shop. It's when we were in Pavoka. I caught that when I was watching. I'm like, that's not the armor shop, Eric. That's the weapon shop. So, yeah, I kind of screwed up. But, oh, well. Broadsword, 225 gold. We have 8,500. Not bad, if I do say so myself. So, I'm going to check magic. So, I need one more for me for level 4s, and then we're all caught up. So, I think before we leave town, we're going to head up to get the last one. And yes, we are going to go left and go see what we can get. We're going to go to the white magic shop because there's nothing really good left in the black magic shop that I want. So we're going to buy, thinking about it, we are going to get Asuna for the red mage. So the red mage and the white mage both have it, so that way we're really covered for on all sides for poison. I know some people will be like, you should have got like Muddle or something. Well, Muddle barely works, so I don't think it was a good buy to get that. So it's just like, yeah, get Asuna, even though we're going to have a whole bunch of potions or antidotes. So we're going to buy a couple cottages to stock up on those, and I get some more gold needles because we're going to be coming across a lot of cockatrices when we hit the Terra Cavern. So I want to be ready for that because I'm sure we're going to get stoned until we get protection rings equipped, which will be much, much, much later. It's good to have those on hand. But now we're back in Cornelia at the castle, so we're going to head into alongside the wall here. And we're going to head up to the treasure chest room and get the stuff in this room. I'm not going to talk to this guy because he'll just say mystic key, blah, blah, blah. Same with that guy here. So we got a crozier, a saber, and a mithril knife. We can use a mithril knife. We'll give that to Alex. The other ones we'll sell. Steel plate, selling. Iron shield, selling. Nobody can use it. We will try, but we're going to end up selling it. And we have the nitro powder. So now we got to go back to the dwarf cave, the dwarf mountain, or whatever they call it. And we're going to give the powder to him so he can finish the canal and we can drive the ship through it. So this has been a very productive episode. Getting a lot done here. So we'll give this guy his...
Holy mitro powder! Thanks a ton, youngsters! Now we can build a canal! Hee-hee! There we go. There, now we can blast this rock to smithereens. Now move it! That wall will explode, so we'd better get out of here! Shit!
Run!
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 Oh, the walls are crumbling down. There it is, the canal is open. Neat.
Oh, the great sea is calling me.
And there he goes. He's going to go run off. So we're going to go into this treasure room, which is locked with the key. We got the key. So we're going to go clean this room out, and then we're going to head back to the Temple of Chaos. Grand Helm, tent will be useful. Worm Killer, Mithril Knife, the Helmet. Most of this we're going to sell. Another Mithril Mail, or a Mithril Mail, 575. And a Cottage, which becomes helpful. So I think of all that stuff, the Mail is the only one we can use. Worm Killer is not as good as this Mithril Sword. The Worm Killer is going to be sold. But we are going to switch the to Mithril Mail for Eric. And everything else is pretty much, yeah. We're going to sell it. So we're going to head back to Cornelia, sell some stuff, save, and then we're going to head up to the Temple of Chaos. So I'm going to go right here. There's a room. But we're going to face some monsters first. Some skeletons. We're going to run from these guys. This is the last time we're going to be visiting Temple of Chaos until the end of the game. So we will get what's in these rooms as we get attacked again. Some zombies. She's going to hit them with... Nope, we're going to flee. There's two of them to our four, so I think I feel lucky. So we get out of here. And we get a gargoyle right here. It's always gargoyles when you enter these rooms. Just two of them. We've run from them before, so we can do it again. Well, at least two of our guys couldn't run, but Kelly gets out of it for us. So we have the rune blade. This is a great sword to use. Unfortunately, it's not as good as the Mithril Sword. It's good against special casting foes, but unfortunately, nobody can use it. Or, well, Eric can use it, but it's not as good as the sword he's already got. So we're going to end up selling it. So now we'll go up and get the other sword that's available. There's a goal. We'll just go ahead and knock him out. I love that. Eric and that sword, just really good. That's probably going to be his sword until almost the end of the game. I'm sure when we find some more swords that he can use, like in the water fall, or maybe when we get to get the Mass Immune in the Temple of Chaos at the end, we'll give it to him. Another encounter here. This will be gargoyles. We're going to run. We're going to have to face them again as we leave here, but we're going to get this done. Werebane and a golden needle. Golden needle will be helpful. So the Werebane sword, same thing as the Rune Blade. I can use it, but it's weaker than the Mithril sword, so we're gonna end up selling it. So that's the story on that one, as we gotta face these guys yet again. And we gotta get out of here. We gotta get out of here. So now it's time to run. And we got some zombies. We're gonna try and run again. We do. So I think that's gonna be the end of this episode. We're gonna go, next time we'll be in Milmond. I'm gonna go grind and get some more money. If you like this episode, hit that like button. Leave a comment if you like, subscribe to the channel. If you'd like to help out with future projects, please visit my Patreon at patreon.com/mntwins28. You do not have to help, but any help is always greatly appreciated. Until next time, peace out.